I'm getting too old for this nonsense.
Yo-ho. Yo-ho. A pirate's life for me. And I will admit, my videos may be delayed, late, or very, very weird, depending on my mood of imagining how to do stuff, but it seems like, you know, I got a little creative juice flowing here and there. So anyway, Shadow Harvester is here with Fall Guys, and we got YoHo. Skulls and crossbones, pirate themes, and yes, yes. Now let's see how Squad Show hits us this time. Full tilt. Full tilt. How is full tilt going to tilt us to our inevitable little moments that we can take care of? And all right, everything's working fine, everything's recording and all that, and I'm sure you guys can hear my magnificent voice with all the gargles and mumbles, because it feels like many moons ago my voice is like, hey everyone, now it's like, that's what it sounds like to me, at least in the morning, where I barely, my eyes aren't exactly the most motivated. My legs get a little wobbly, like I have two left feet or two right feet. And, you know, it's like the whole haven't had my morning coffee routine. And you just don't know how the world's gonna go here and there. I know how the world's gonna go, especially like my world. It's usually either going to be a Fall Guy video, a video in general, or just me like, well, it's a rainy day. I don't have an umbrella. I do have an umbrella, but it's, I think someone grabbed the umbrella along with me, and apparently it may or may not have broke it in a way. Which stinks, because I think that umbrella was only used once. Because I was in the parking lot of a store, and it decided to rain down hard. And I'm like, you know what, I'll just go buy an umbrella, and I did. And then somehow I couldn't get it back down, and then someone grabbed it. I grabbed it, and then apparently it might have caused some shenanigan problems. And yeah. Alright, so we can either look here at this cheese head, or we can go ahead and actually see what is going on with these beans lasting and going into the line of the finish. Third place though. So, that's a good thing. It usually is. Never put a bean down, you know? Because you never know if it's going to be a qualified or an elimination. You just don't know. So, yeah. So, let's see how the skull and crossbones go. Pixel painters. I don't think many pirates back in the day were well to do with pixels and paint. Well, I don't know. Maybe paint. Because I'm sure paint is one of those building blocks of life. It's like a Rubik's Cube type of thing. That, well, most of us are acquainted with. Believe me, I probably sweat buckets of paint, you know? And yeah, we got beings that are not caring at all. You can tell. I'm pretty sure the names give it away too, you know? Putrid Trout may sound like a good nickname at this point compared to all this trash talking. Makes you wonder how these beings that are actually people, surprisingly. I know. How can these awful beings be people and still somehow function in life, you know? Yeah, they get away with this trash, you know? It's just unfunny. I like how the other being left when they weren't even doing anything either. They were joining in on the fun of this. Well, I guess these skull and crossbones have another... Well, you know. It's bad enough we get eliminated when I do stupid things, but, you know, having something like this happen when you can't control... My only hope is they all leave and I can somehow muster the strength to do this, but I know that's impossible. And it's even funny because most of the time these people give up. Like, yeah, already. I can see you do that. And there's no little point. So, I could just go ahead and report you, in all honesty. There is no point of this, so... There's literally no way we're gonna win. Because this bean will not let me do anything, and then they're just gonna watch. You know, actually do something with your life instead of mocking people who actually want to play a game. You know? Maybe this is a good thing. That life is better when it's a single player than it, when you're playing with a group of people. Because, you know, sure, you got backups. Sure, it boosts the commentary. Of course, the very last one. And as usual, my little left and right feet delay stuff. That's the difference between people and myself. I may be a little goofy and a little delayed at certain things. And I've noticed that, especially when I read, like, RPG text. Sometimes I say the wrong thing, and then sometimes it takes forever to do, or everybody else just reads perfect, because apparently everybody's perfect. Kind of thing. But I'm not going to falsely force people to have delay when it comes to completely and utterly ruining the game by senseless trollish behavior. Yep. Big fans are here. You know, I'm pretty sure the internet was one of those greatest things. And nowadays it's just like, just, why can't we just be Amish? You know? No internet, no people constantly ganging up to prove how cool they are with their inferiority complex. Yeah, you know, everything is just, you know, it's like, what could have been? And like, nope, this will never be good. And, oh, will this be good? Like, almost every time there's a video of something coming out, it's like, oh, will this be good? Will this be good? I mean, we got people literally going out of their way, spending other people's money at this point, because if we know other people just give a crap load of money to people who do not want to do it on their own, and somehow they're hailed as heroes, Got people playing freaking video games or buying them based off of like Cartoon Network and Disney, Nickelodeon, stuff like that. Those are the games I would never buy. That's why I would never try to 100% collect every single game of a console, because I don't want those trashy games. I don't want those trashy celebrity games. I mean, if I want to play like Rock Band, yeah. But do I want to play some trashy singer game? No. I'd rather play a game with this ice cream creature than, say, one of those idiots that ruined pixel painters. So, yeah. I don't know where I'm going with anything I say, honestly. I don't make this stuff up either. Because if I write a script, it's going to be full of misspelled words and really weird moments. So, might as well just say it 100% with my vocal cords. Because, yeah. And then I do carry on sometimes. So if I did write a script, you probably wouldn't hear me do that. And there's times where I forgot to hook the microphone up on some of these videos. And I literally don't talk like this. It's just like, so I just talk about the game. Where now, it's just like, I just talk about random stuff. It's like, oh hey, I found a nickel on the floor the other day. Or something like that, instead of talking about Slime Climb. I don't know how a being like that can function without the top half of its body, but I guess that chicken bone is a sentient being. Has all of its nervous and, well, brain-like veins running around. Okay, okay. Whoa. Now. Okay, alright. Ooh. We got this climb. It's about time. We muster the strength of our accuracy. And our brain power. There's only two things that can screw me up now. My ill-fated timing and the dang game running out of time while we're up on the top. Okay, Slime Climb is not that bad of a game. And okay, normally in video games, like, if I can't see the bottom of the, like, if we're, like, up in the sky or something, I will go very, very, very slowly. But if we're also, like, I probably would have fell there if we were set for time, where the goo was actually up. Yeah, the goo didn't even reach these last couple of floors. So, that's a good thing. I am actually surprised they didn't put the skull and crossbones free. YoHo, on the front of our bean chest. And then we get this other one. We already climbed slime. Now we got a slime climb again with the scrapper. It's literally like we're going up a skyscraper type of thing. For all we know, the next round could be space. So we literally climbed into space or something. Different dimensions, you know? We're basically in the future. future is indeed whatever you make it, so make it a good one. I always quote that line from Back to the Future Part 3, and it's relevant. It is very relevant for when you need it, you know? Resources are resources. So, grab the bull by the horn. And, alright. I go figure. I'm wasting time waiting for a door that may or may not want to open. Okay, usually here we got, like, blocks that want to push us. So, okay. And only I would have trouble with laser-gridded fencing. I mean, this is also coming from me, who used to have a hard time with this. Because I think one of the first times we actually played this game, I either died in the very beginning area, or I died right there by the slime. Okay. Whoa, geez. Yes, push me over here, which is probably our best place to be. Okay, yeah. Go figure. Ill-fated timeouts, you know? Everybody's got them. Somewhere, somehow, some way. And yeah, well, I just want to see what the results entail in some places here and there. So, yeah. Panther mech. Ooh, ferocious. And some show bucks. Alright, nice. Panther mech is taken care of. And we're getting leveled up. Alright. That final stretch. After this, there's about like 8. I want to say. Because, yeah. Alright. Because we're at 61. There's only 70 of this fame pass. So, yeah, we're getting there. So, to everybody who's reached this point, we are going to end it here. Of course, because it's a nice day and I kind of want to do something before it goes away from all the rain. So, like, comment, subscribe, and I, Shadow Harvester, will see you next time for more Fall Guy fun. Bye-bye.